Hello and welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallard and today we're going to look at how we can use the tree command to display information from our file system. To begin with, you can see I'm logged on as an ordinary user. I'm the user Bob. I'm actually using a CentOS 6 machine. There are different distributions of Linux. CentOS is one, SUSE, Fedora, Debian are others. If you're used to using the Raspberry Pi, then you're using a Debian-based distribution. In this example, we're going to look at using CentOS, but we'll look at another example very soon where we use Ubuntu, which is going to be very similar to what you're using if you're using a Raspberry Pi. If I want to list a file system tree, I could use something like ls. If I use ls with minus capital R, let's take a look on CentOS, just at, let's say, the etc directory and yum. And there we can see that it prints then the etc yum directory and its content, including traversing down to the subdirectories plugin conf.d, protected.d, and vars. So we can see everything from that directory down. But it's not, if you like, in a nice tree format. So we could try using the command tree. But if we type it, at the moment, we don't have the tree command installed. Now, generally in Linux, when we install software, we're going to find the software located in the internet in software repositories. I can clear my screen just using Control and L. If I search for this, I can use yum. Yum is just the command that we're going to use to search and install software when we're using CentOS. If we're using a Debian-based system, such as a Raspberry Pi, or Ubuntu, or Debian itself, then we could use the command apt, or various forms of the command apt. But for the moment, we're on a CentOS machine, so we're going to use yum. And I can use yum and list tree. So we can see there is a package available. And we've gone through and we've searched various internet-based repositories. And we've returned then one package. To be able to install that, then we can use yum install. Now you're going to see that I was able to search for the package, but if I try install it as a standard user, then we say that we need to be root to be able to perform that information. As we saw before, I can use Control L, but there is also a clear command. So Control L will clear the screen, as will the clear command. Very often we can gain root privileges by running the command with sudo in front of it. So if I go sudo yum install tree, so long as I've got writes within the sudoers file to be able to do this, then I will be able to. It's going to prompt me for my password, but it doesn't have to. It depends on how it's been configured. But we can see now we're going ahead and running the installation. With the tree command installed now, if I go back up and we run the similar command that we looked at before, but this time using tree. So if we go through and look at the yum directory, we can see now we get the display in a nice tree format. But say during this demonstration, we looked at using CentOS. CentOS, Red Hat, and Fedora are all very similar, and you may be using those either at home or within your classroom situation. But if you're using the Raspberry Pi, let's look at how we could do this on an Ubuntu-based system. So I'm now working on an Ubuntu machine. An Ubuntu machine is a Debian-based distribution, and that's the same type of system as you're using on a Raspberry Pi. The same thing really applies. I can try running the tree command, but we can see that the command is not found. Similarly to what we saw with yum, we can use apt to search and install. And as a standard user, I can then run apt cache and search for tree. We can see we've got an awful lot of output there. If we change this and just put the uppercase 6 or the caret symbol in front of the word tree, we then say now the package doesn't just contain the string tree, but it will start with the string tree. So when we look at the output now, we're only seeing package names that include tree at the start of the name or start of the description. So now we can go through and use sudo. We're going to need writes to be able to install this, apt get, and we can see the advantage of using control L. Whilst in the middle of a line, I can use control L, my line code stays there but just moves to the top of the screen. So sudo apt get install tree. Once that's ready, again, let's clear the screen and then just use something like tree/etc/apt. And there we can see, rather than the yum directory that we were looking at before, we're now looking at the apt directory. Both of these directories are to do with installing software. On CentOS machine, it's yum, and on Debian-based systems, including the Raspberry Pi and Ubuntu, it's then apt. So etc apt, and we can see then that tree then lists it. We can see here the output may not be quite as nice. We've got these dashed lines, but if we go and have a look at the command tree, so if I go tree minus minus help, we can see then there are a lot of options that we can pass through to this. One of which, if we move up a little bit, is the char set, minus minus char set. So if I clear this out, and then we can go back, and if we use it now with tree minus minus char set equals UTF minus 8 in capital letters, we get a more tidy output, much in the same way that we saw with the output from the CentOS machine. So hopefully this gives you an idea of the tree command and how it can be used to display a graphical layout of your file system hierarchy.